Children of Dune. Children of Dune is a 1976 science fiction novel by Frank Herbert, the third in his Dune series of six novels. Initially selling over 75,000 copies, it became the first hardcover bestseller ever in the science fiction field. The novel was critically well received for its gripping plot, action, and atmosphere, and was nominated for the Hugo Award for Best Novel in 1977. It was originally serialized in Analog Science Fiction and Fact in 1976, and was the last Dune novel to be serialized before book publication. The novels Dune Messiah and Children of Dune were published in one volume by Science Fiction Book Club in 2002, and the two were adapted into a well-received television miniseries entitled Frank Herbert's Children of Dune by the Sci-Fi Channel in 2003. At the end of Dune Messiah, Paul Atreides walks into the desert, a blind man, leaving his twin children Leto and Ganima in the care of the Freeman, while his sister Aelia rules the universe as regent. Awakened in the womb by the spice, the children are the heirs to Paul's prescient vision of the fate of the universe, a role that Aelia desperately craves. House Carino schemes to return to the throne, while the Bene Gesserit make common cause with the Tlaloxu and Spacing Guild to gain control of the spice and the children of Paul Atreides. Dune traces the rise of Paul Muad'Dib, a young nobleman in an interstellar feudal empire who takes control of the single critical resource in the universe, the lifespan-enhancing, consciousness-expanding drug spice mélange. As the first book closes, Paul has triumphed. His scheming, evil enemies are dead or overthrown, and he is set to take the reins of power and bring a hard but enlightened peace to the universe. Herbert chose in the books that followed to undermine Paul's triumph with a string of failures and philosophical paradoxes. Dune was a heroic melody, and Dune Messiah was its inversion. When the second novel, Dune Messiah, opens, Muad'Dib's religion has sent his fanatical soldiers on an interstellar jihad, destroying the traditional structures of government and leaving billions dead. His vision of peace is corrupted by dogmatic religious bureaucrats, and his once noble desert tribes, the Freemen, grow fat and wealthy on the spoils of war and the desertification of Dune. 9 years after Emperor Paul Muad'Dib walked into the desert, blind, the ecological transformation of Dune has reached the point where some Freemen are living without stillsuits in the less arid climate and have started to move out of the sieges and into the villages and cities. As the old ways erode, more and more pilgrims arrive to experience the planet of Muad'Dib. The Imperial High Council has lost its political might and is powerless to control the jihad. Paul's young twin children, Leto II and Ganima, have concluded that their guardian Aelia has succumbed to abomination, the possession by one of her ancestors, and fear that a similar fate awaits them. They, and Aelia, also realize that the terraforming of Dune will kill all the sandworms, thus destroying the source of Thespis, but the thing which has possessed Aelia desires this outcome. Leto also fears that, like his father, he will be trapped by his prescience. Possessed by the persona of her grandfather Baron Vladimir Harkonnen, Aelia fears that her mother Lady Jessica, about to return to Arrakis, will recognize her abomination. Meanwhile, a new religious figure called the Preacher has risen in the desert, railing against the religious government's injustice and the changes among the Freemen. Some Freemen believe he is Paul Atreides. Princess Wenzisha of the Fallen House Carino and Seleucus Secundus plots to assassinate the twins and regain power. Jessica returns to Arrakis and recognizes that her daughter has been possessed, but finds no signs of abomination in the twins. Leto arranges for Freeman leader Stilgar to protect his sister if there is an attempt on their lives. The Preacher journeys to Seleucus Secundus to meet Wenzisha and Faradin, and in return pledges Duncan Idaho as an agent of House Carino. Aelia attempts to assassinate Jessica, who escapes into the desert with Duncan Shelp, precipitating a rebellion among the Freemen. The twins anticipate and survive the Carino assassination plot. Leto leaves to seek out the Preacher while Ganima, masking her memory with self-hypnosis, reports falsely that her brother had been murdered. Duncan and Jessica flee to Seleucus Secundus, where Jessica begins to mentor the Carino heir. He seizes power from his regent mother Wenzisha and allies with the Bene Gesserit, who promise to marry him to Ganima and support his bid for coronation as emperor. A band of Freeman outlaws capture Leto and force him to undergo the spice trance at the suggestion of Gurney Halleck, who has infiltrated the group on Jessica's orders. His spice-induced visions show him a myriad of possible futures where humanity has become extinct and only one where humanity survives. He names this future the Golden Path and resolves to bring it to fruition, something that his father, who had already glimpsed this future, refused to do. He escapes his captors and sacrifices his humanity in pursuit of the golden path by physically fusing with a school of sand trout, gaining superhuman strength and near invulnerability. He travels across the desert and confronts the preacher who does, in fact, prove to be Paul. Duncan returns to Arrakis and provokes Stilgar into killing him. With Stilgar's neutrality now untenable, he seizes Ghanima and flees. Aelia recaptures Ghanima and arranges her marriage to Faradin, planning to exploit the expected chaos when Ghanima kills him to avenge her brother's murder. The preacher and Leto return to the capital to confront Aelia, who has the preacher murdered, revealing his true identity. Leto reveals himself in a display of superhuman strength and triggers the return of Ghanima's genuine memories. He confronts Aelia and offers to help her overcome her possession, but she is overwhelmed by her ancestral personae and elects to commit suicide. Leto declares himself emperor and asserts control over the freemen. Faradin enlists in his service and delivers control of the Carino armies. The seemingly immortal and omnipotent Leto is left as emperor of the known universe, with Ghanima at his side. Leto symbolically marries her, but allows her to take Faradin, renamed Harkalata, breaking of habit, and appointed royal scribe, as her consort so the Atreides line can continue. Initially selling over 75,000 copies, Children of Dune became the first hardcover bestseller ever in the science fiction field. The novel was critically well received for its gripping plot, action, and atmosphere, and was nominated for the Hugo Award for Best Novel in 1977. In a 1976 review, Spider Robinson found Children of Dune unsatisfying, faulting the ending as unconvincing and thematically overfamiliar. The novel is referenced in A Thousand Plateaus, 1980, by Gilles Deleuze and Félix Guattari. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.